party in their own personal style.
I like the wobble.
Let me out!
Shoot me now.
At the end of every night, they'll mark each other in secret.
Oh, my God, it's flopped.
Not good. Not good.
So temperatures rise. As they compete to take home a £1,000 prize. It's the last day, and one of our Leicester cooks will soon pocket the money. First to cook for the cash was curry lover Sue Massey. But her spice wasn't right, and she scored an ordinary 24 points out of 40. On night two, market trader Liam Reed set his stall out.
Whatever hiccups have come along, them they have tried my hardest, so win or lose, I would lose.
That seems fair enough, as he took the lead with 31 points. Yeah! On night three, Rhea Thomas kicked up a storm. But she hit a bum note with one of her guests.
Quite surprised me, because I thought, I'm asking you to clap, I'm not asking you to stand out there and dance it.
As a result, she scored just 28 points. Yesterday was the turn of family man Russell Dunmore, whose menu of five different dishes meant he had a lot to juggle in the kitchen.
Oops. I can't remember which one was Sue's.
But his night still proved a big hit as he stormed into the lead with a weighty 34 points.
I'm pleased with what I've done tonight, but Stephanie's still the competition, I think.
Yep, 38-year-old Stephanie Heimer is the only person that stands between Russell and the £1,000, and she's hardly lacking for confidence in the kitchen.
I actually believe that I can produce better tasting foods than a lot of restaurants. My presentation mightn't be towering in restaurant style, but the flavours are definitely there.
Well, she might see herself as the best cook in Leicester, but she's going to have her work cut out if she's going to trump Russell, who scored a maximum from Sue.
I gave Russell a 10 because everything about the evening was perfection.
Tick, tuck.
The best moment for me last night was Claire singing. Not quite sure how Steph felt about it.
To be honest, I wish someone would shoot me now because all my worst nightmares have come true. I've been exposed to other people's children singing at me.
And Steph's party pooper attitude has led to her becoming the outsider of the group.
I think there is an element of superiority about Stephanie.
Last night I was trying to ask Stephanie if she was posh. But I think what I really meant was, are you a snob?
I mean, really, nobody brings out their children usually to sing, and nobody has a full can-can dancing team, you know, at their usual dinner parties.
But... Well, they do in Leicester.
Fantastic.
And if being the outsider isn't enough, experienced party host Stephanie also knows she has a tough job on her hands to win everyone over with her fancy menu.
Liam and Rhea, I don't really think it's up their street. I mean, if I'd known it was Liam and Rhea, no offence to them, but I would have done something like steak and chips and, you know, something just plain and simple.
I really don't know what Stephanie will cook tonight. I haven't got a clue. I've just got a feeling it's going to be bland, something that I probably won't enjoy.
Nice to see you keeping an open mind. Stephanie's starting with prawns pilpil with fennel seed bread.
Prawns pilpil, I suspect that's something with some chilli in it. And I don't mind if she wants to put a little or a lot, I can tackle that one.
I haven't got a clue what that could be. I'm guessed something with some kind of sedation in it, so everyone gives her a good score.
Yeah, I reckon you're thinking about a different sort of pill. Stephanie's off to her local wine merchants for advice on serving the right wine to complement her food.
Hi, Duncan.
Hello, Steph. You're
How
right.
Are you?
I'm all right, thank you.
My main thing was I wanted a white and a red for every course.
Yeah, that's all right. So what are you doing?
Thanks for asking, Dunk. For her main course, it's Stilton and asparagus roulade.
Interesting choice.
I might have a problem with the Stilton. I am not a lover of pongo cheeses.
Asparagus would be sort of top of the list of vegetables that I really don't like.
There ain't no meat in it, so... It's the kind of thing you'd think. It's not something you should feed a guinea pigs, you know what I mean?
tingly in the mouth.
Roulade, guinea pigs. Wonder if they'd like a good red to wash it down with.
It's got that lovely, vibrant fruit. It's got lots of Merlot, lots of Sanso, lots of Grenache. It's kind of like a southern French Bordeaux crossover style. As soon as you open it, you go, oh, got to drink it all. It's absolutely fabulous.
I think we all need a drink after that spiel.
Thank you very much, Duncan.
With the wine sorted, Stephanie's waved off, rather self-consciously, and she heads back to the favourite room in her house, the kitchen.
We actually had this custom built, and when we first saw the house, this was a partition wall, and we just knew that we could knock it down and build a kitchen diner. This is kind of my pride and joy, which is the range cooker. Because it's my toy, my husband's not really allowed to drive it, so, yeah, it's just for me. And then over here is what we call our toddler.
Toddler? Looks like a coffee machine.
Basically, you press a button, it grinds the beans for you, and you have the perfect coffee every time, and it does lattes, espresso, whatever you want.
Who's a clever boy? It's time for Stephanie to put her swanky kitchen to good use. And first up, she prepares the roulade. She starts by mixing 65 grams of butter with 100 grams of flour and 425 millilitres of milk before stirring over a high heat.
I'm basically making the bechamel sauce, which is the basis of the roulade. And the original recipe does say to make it in stages. You make the roux first and add the milk little by little. But Delia says you can do the all-in-one method, and I agree with her. It's a much quicker and more efficient way of doing things.
Once it's thickened, Stephanie, separates 6 eggs before adding the yolks in one at a time.
What you've got to be really careful of is only to add one in at a time, because otherwise it's going to curdle. So this is probably one of the most dangerous times of cooking the roulade.
Having fought off the dire threat of curdling, she whisks the egg whites to a stiff peak before folding them into the mixture. She then pours into a baking tray.
Now that's done, I need to put it straight in the oven, otherwise it just collapses.
With the roulade in the oven for 25 minutes, there's time for a quick tidy-up.
I'm sort of slightly OCD in that I like everything to be just so and really neat and tidy and things, and I need to feel in control of things.
And perfectionist Stephanie takes her cleanliness to extreme levels.
I'm a bit hyacinth bouquet that way. I actually dishwash my milk bottles before I put them out.
Lucky old milkman. Next, Steph prepares the dough for her fennel bread by mixing olive oil with 250 millilitres of water before adding her secret ingredient.
And I once read a recipe which told you to put Coffee Mate in and just make the bread taste better and the texture was better.
Interesting! In then go flour, dried yeast and 2 tablespoons of fennel seeds.
Prawn and fennel goes well together. Well, fennel and any fish does.
While the dough bakes in a bread oven for an hour and a half, the roulade is ready.
It's looking good, actually. Yeah, it's looking, well, if I say so myself, perfect.
Yes, of course you would. Steph then spreads cream cheese over the roulade before adding some caramelised onions, followed by asparagus, some Stilton...
And you just crumble it in, really.
..and a handful of walnuts. She then starts the tricky job of rolling it up.
It doesn't matter if a few bits come off, as long as it doesn't break, because no one will notice once it's been cooked again.
Finally, she wraps the roll tightly in greaseproof paper, followed by tin foil.
And that's now ready to go in the fridge.
It needs 4 hours to set before going into the oven again, so Steph turns her attention to dessert. Sweet baked ricotta with raspberry sorbet.
I'm not really sure what ricotta is. Is that what we had last night at Russell's?
No.
That was panna cotta, wasn't it?
Yes. I think you got your otters mixed up.
Sweet baked ricotta with a raspberry sorbet. Great, so we ain't got no meat tonight.
What were you expecting, steak and custard?
There's a lot of cheese on the menu, and I do like cheese.
Yeah, there is a lot of cheese on the menu. So is Stephanie having doubts about her dishes?
When I first devised the menu, funnily enough, I thought it was fail-safe because it was all things that my friends really loved to eat and enjoy, and my family as well. I know Stilton and cream cheese and then ricotta, which is another cheese, could be a bit heavy, but, I mean, ricotta is actually quite low-fat and isn't that creamy, so I think it'd be absolutely fine.
Well, if you're sure. To make the dessert, Steph measures out some sugar and flour before adding orange marmalade, 4 packs of ricotta, 2 eggs, vanilla essence, and lemon juice.
And the last thing in is basically the booze. And you can use most things, but I'm using brandy.
Finally, the blended ricotta mix goes into the oven for an hour at 170 degrees. And with her preparations going smoothly so far, how confident is she about winning the £1,000 prize?
I've got the feeling that I like different things to other people. So, you know, one man's meat is another man's poison.
Yeah, but there isn't actually any meat on the menu, is there?
Yeah, I'm a bit disappointed with that because I had a feeling she was going to do something stupid, like, without any meat.
If you too want to cook something stupid, or rather vegetarian, then visit the Channel 4 website. With the fennel seed dough ready, Stephanie cuts it into portions. Places it onto a baking tray before putting it into the oven to bake. And with time ticking away until her guests arrive, Steph gets her prawn starter ready by chopping up some chilli and garlic.
I had something called prawns peel when I went to Spain, and I could never work out what the aniseed flavour was, and then just one day I was struck by inspiration and I stuck in some star anise. Looks like this. It's just a very strong aniseed flavour.
Added to that goes olive oil and tomato sauce. And finally, frozen prawns.
I like to think of it as easy to make and high impact, and the great thing about it is you can have it all ready to go in the oven when your guests arrive.
Ta-da! Steph's timing is perfect, as she's finished all her preparation just as her first guest arrives. It's Ria.
Hello, Ria.
Hi, Ria. Come on in. How are you?
You look lovely.
Good to you. How are you?
Followed by Russell.
Hello. You're right.
Yes, thank you.
Then Sue.
Nice to meet you again. Oh,
thank you.
Hello. Before Liam completes the party.
Looking
thank
well.
You very much. Thank you.
Hey, you're right.
Come and see.
Coming up.
Come
Sue
on.
Lets the cat out of the bag.
Think it's okay to let him out?
Oh, I don't know.
Stephanie makes a startling revelation about how she met her husband.
I've been on 46 first dates before I met Kevin.
46?
Before the winner is crowned.
Ooh, yeah, beauty.
Start. Start up more than games. Start a home entertainment revolution. Start streaming your music video playlist with VidZone. Start catching up on the latest programmes on BBC iPlayer. Start Blu-ray movies in high definition. Start seeing more detail than ever before. Start getting more from your games console. The new PlayStation 3 for $249.99. The game is just the start.
Make Sunday night fun day night with Bingo Lotto. Join us for a night in with the nation and play along live every Sunday for fun, games and loads of prizes. With up to £100,000, cars, holidays and lots more to be won. Come on, Britain, are you in? Buy a game card from Tesco and we'll see you on the sofa.
And you're back in the room.
Introducing the...
Great! I've just been humiliated in front of 1,200 people, sir!
You choose the bread, the filling, the salad, and the sauce.
However you feel, whatever you want.
We've got a sub for that.
Go on. Hold on, she's caught. Wrong angle. Push it. No, son, over. And then up. Yeah. Oh, push!
Hey, that's it.
When we deliver your new appliance, we'll recycle the old one free of charge, and we'll even take away the packaging. Currys, we can help.
If you're looking for more lower prices on your favourite brands, just take a look at this Monday's independent price check. They found that Asda had more lower prices on average than Tesco and Sainsbury's, and lots more than Morrison's. So, come and see how much you could save. Asda, saving you money every day.
Oi! Buy your Bingo Lotto game card at Tesco and play along live every Sunday. Come on, Britain, are you in?
At Bright House, they let me pay weekly for the things I need, so at least my money doesn't get into a mess. Getting an LCD TV from Bright House was easy because there's no scary credit checks.
Affording the sofa from Bright House wasn't a problem. It's relaxing that's difficult.
At Bright House, you can pay weekly, there's no credit checks, and loads of top quality brands and products to choose from. So whatever you want for your house, you could afford it with Bright House, the nation's weekly payment store.
Some people believe skipping breakfast makes them slimmer. In fact, research shows that people who eat a low-fat breakfast cereal, like Special K, tend to be slimmer than those who don't. For other great ways to help manage your shape successfully, go online for your free personal plan at specialk.co.uk.
Tonight, police investigate allegations of torture by MI6 officers. 4 years after the collapse of Rover, the report accusing the directors of wrongly paying themselves millions, and the Sri Lankan government answers questions on the shocking video claimed to show the extrajudicial killing of Tamil prisoners by soldiers during the war. We'll see you at 7 o'clock.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
After four parties, psychology teacher Stephanie Heimer is last to host, and she's hoping to beat current leader Russell to the £1,000.
Yeah, so I'd like to welcome you all to the last night.
And while she pops to the kitchen, Russ and animal lover Sue venture outside to meet Steph's pedigree cat, Kim Cat Otto Borrower's Delight. And yes, that really is his name.
Come and see Susan. Come on.
Think it's okay to let him out?
Oh, I don't know. Just lost the... Is it supposed to come out?
No.
What a beauty...
But never fear, in a cat crisis, Sue's to the rescue.
So, Sue! Sue! Ow!
Or maybe not.
What's his name? I don't mean to manhandle you. I'm coming into the house with you this time.
Just put him through there and
I'll... No, I want to get in with him.
Oh, do you? OK, then.
Thank you. There!
I'll see you when the taxis come.
Bye! Can I have my dinner in here?
Blissfully unaware of the pandemonium outside, Stephanie is preparing her prawn starter.
Right, that'll take 20 minutes and that's done.
Hopefully that'll give Sue time to escape.
Let me out! Let me out!
Let's just start eating, eh, before Steph finds out. First up tonight, she's serving prawns pil-pil with fennel bread.
Do you guys want to help yourself to the wines?
That
seeds?
Smells lovely.
Yeah, it does. Right,
this bread is to go with it, and it's got fennel seeds in it to sort of complement the prawns. Now, there's just one thing about the dishes that you've got. You've all got a star anise in there, like a little starfish. Mm-hmm. Don't chew that.
I found your starfish, Steph. Mm. Is that really hot then, yeah?
It's not hot, it's just, it's not very pleasant to eat. So you can try it if you want.
Oh, I wouldn't do that.
I think it'd work with king prawns as well.
It'd work really well with king prawns. I think it'd work with chicken as well. Mm, not anything, really.
Excellent.
Right, beautiful.
Altogether, it was quite nice.
The fennel bread, yeah, nothing spectacular, but all the same, edible.
That was absolutely beautiful.
Thank you, Liam.
I wanted to not like it because I thought how Steph had been with everyone. So I can't knock her for her food. The food was lovely.
And if you want another
so it seems so far so good for Stephanie in her quest for the £1,000. And to strengthen her improving relations with the group, she shares a startling revelation about her husband.
We met on the internet. The thing about Kevin was, he was actually my first date number 46. So I've been on 46 first dates before I met Kevin.
46?
Oh, my God.
46, yeah.
Did you meet 46 really interesting people?
So by number 46, it was like, right, so what do you do?
Yeah.
You just sound as funny journey in. What car do you drive?
I don't know. I reckon you could have some good fun 46 dates before.
I'm sure you could, Liam, you rascal.
What period was that over?
Yeah, a year.
Oh, my gosh.
But yes, at one point...
That's nearly
a month and a half.
So, yes, nearly 1 week, isn't it?
Yeah.
Make it sound like a shift work. Finding out that Steph met her husband on the internet was
was really interesting and not something I would have expected.
I don't know, I just had this perception that Steph would be someone that perhaps married someone that was a family friend or, you know, a well-to-do kind of chap, which I'm sure her husband is, but it did quite surprise me.
So the ice might be breaking between Stephanie and the others, but now comes her toughest task, winning them over with her meat-free main course. Stilton and asparagus roulade.
It's like a savoury Swiss roll.
You did, okay.
What's the idea behind the vegetarian free main course? Is it just another twist?
What it is, a fair share of my friends are vegetarians.
All right.
So when I've got people coming around for dinner, I don't want to cook two courses.
Yeah.
So I like and try and cook something more creative, you know, rather than your bog standard lasagna, vegetarian lasagna and that kind of thing. So that was just one of the dishes I cook for them, really.
Is this your main course?
Yes, it is, dear.
Yes, sir. You've had so many so far, haven't
you? No, Rosie, she pudding.
Oi, that's my line.
It's a starter, babe.
Oh, trapped. Oh, it is a starter.
No! Oh, he's winding you up now.
Oh, come on, it's not that difficult.
You are winding me up now.
Yes.
Now, I've got a confession to make here.
Oh, no. Oh.
I was slightly apprehensive of this because I don't like Stilton. But do you know what? You can't taste the Stilton because it's actually melded, moulded, melted even into the roulade.
I think that's Sue speak for it tastes bland.
I thought the Stilton was going to overpower us a little bit, but actually I found it quite hard to taste the Stilton.
If I got at a restaurant as a main course, I'd be like, well peed off. It wouldn't be my cup of tea.
So it turns out Stephanie's choice of veggie main has backfired, but her decision to serve two bottles of wine with each course certainly hasn't.
I've got two more wines for you guys.
Another two bottles.
Can I just compliment you on the wines you've put on the table tonight?
Thank you, Lewis. I'm glad you've enjoyed it.
I just love the fact that you have to drink two bottles of wine with everything you eat. It's great. Can't we have an 11-course meal or something?
And the wine seems to have helped the conversation flow. Oh, steady on, Liam. As Stephanie reveals another secret about herself.
Well, I've had my forehead and my eyes done with Botox. So this is surprise. And this is frown.
You know what? I didn't know about that you'd had Botox. But this is obviously why I can't read you, because when you say something to you, you can't physically pull a face. Yeah, but I'll just say it as, you know, grow old. Gracefully.
That's really easy for you to say at the age of 23.
I'm 24, yeah, I know what you're saying.
Wait till you're 38.
I made it quite clear tonight that, you know, grow old gracefully and we need to see your facial expressions because it can make you come across as quite cold.
Can I have a look at that? Yeah.
Surprise.
So when I go like that.
Frown. I'm not going to stop doing it though because I quite like the effect.
Stephanie may have had Botox, but she's yet to have anything else enhanced, if you don't mind, Rhea.
No, they're my own, Rhea.
Oh! Well, they look good.
Thank you.
They are quite big.
So, fun job.
Steady on, Liam.
Yeah, definitely learned a lot more about Steph tonight because she's really tried, which is such a shame because it is the end of the week, but, yeah, she's really brought herself out tonight. And I think, you know, I wish we could have known her a bit longer.
It looks like Stephanie's finally getting on well with the group, and she's got one last chance to impress them with her dessert. Sweet baked ricotta with raspberry sorbet.
And digging, guys.
The baked ricotta is just so lovely. I don't think that I would have made a cheese main course with a cheese dessert. I would have perhaps done something more contrasting.
I love sweet stuff, but I'm not really into this ricotta stuff.
It tastes like a cereal bar that had been left in your golf bag for about a month in the heat.
Tell us what you really think, Liam. And while you're at it, anything else you'd like to get off your chest? Time for another confession, I think.
On Tuesday's the first night I've ever actually cooked a meal for anyone.
Oh,
I've never cooked anything. Right, I lied. Look, the only thing I could make is a bowl of cereal. That's the only time I've cooked for anyone.
I think that's really amazing, because what you cooked was really, really good, apart from the base on the cheesecake, I have to say.
Considering Liam had never cooked before, he really did an excellent meal.
I think that he's probably practised that a couple of times, even though he said he hasn't. I'm sure he's got to have practised that. But four marks of the guy.
It's been a big night for confessions and revelations. So, truthfully, how has Steph done?
Thought it'd be the worst night out of everyone's, but it's actually been really good.
The atmosphere has been absolutely electric here tonight.
The food was pleasant, but it didn't have that...
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Now for those crucial scores. Stephanie needs 35 points to beat Russell.
Food started off well, but then tailed off slightly, so I'm going to give her a 7.
Starter was the highlight of the evening. Didn't so much enjoy the other courses, and for that reason, I'm giving Steph a 7.
It was well presented, but I'm afraid the menu wasn't really to my taste, and that's why I'm going to give her a 7.
Unfortunately for me, after the starter, the food went downhill. So tonight, I'm going to give Stephanie a 6.
So, Steph scores just 27 points, leaving her a lowly 4th. But the scores are in secret.
Right, here we go.
So it's her job to reveal the winner of the £1,000 to the group.
You said.
And in 5th place, we have Sue. In 4th place, we have me.
Well done, Steph.
In 3rd place, we have Rhea. In 2nd place, we have Liam. With me. Well done, Russell.
Give a kiss. Mwah.
I'm proud and humble with £1,000. My daughter's getting a new camera, and I'm going to blow the rest on my wife.
For a selection of recipes from the show, go to channel4.com/food. Next on 4, Santa's Little Helper gets a taste of fame and the Simpsons want a slice.
They did that press conference, didn't they, when they went to America, and one of the journalists said to John, is Ringo Starr the best drummer in the world? And he said, he's not even the best drummer in the Beatles.
Yeah, that's a great story, isn't it? Ringo took that.
Discover everything you need to know about the Beatles with an exclusive guide to the Fab Four, free this Saturday, only in The Times.
Our secret to strong hair? Damaged hair loses moisture faster and can break more easily. Pantene Repair and Protect Conditioner. Its formula delivers moisturizers to dry areas, then helps lock moisture in. Pantene Repair and Protect leaves hair up to 10 times more resilient against damage. Pantene. Now buy one, get one free on all 4 and 500ml Pantene at Tesco, while stocks last.
Cushion yourself with an ING Direct savings account. ING Direct. Saving feels good.
At Comet this week, there's 20% off any Bosch, Siemens or Neff large appliance when you trade in your old appliance. So this Bosch washing machine could be only £299.20, saving over £70. Comet. We deal in your ideal.
Churchill, can I really count on you for free breakdown cover when I buy car insurance?
Oh, yes.
Bless you.
And UK call centres?
Oh, yes.
Oh.
You can't believe a word he says. He told me he's got an audition for a West End musical.
Here we are, mate.
Oh, no. Oh.
For car insurance with free breakdown cover, count on Churchill. Call or go online.
Lose yourself in Cerf's luxurious new fragrances. Jasmine and black gardenia. Vanilla and black orchid. twilight sensations, the mysterious new fragrances from Surf.